Today we'll see how to operate function generator and cathode ray oscilloscope. These are the two important input devices and output devices used in an electronics laboratory. So this is a function generator, digital function generator. This is a display which shows the frequency and amplitude. These are the various switches. This is the frequency switch. We can select the frequency range from here, 0.1 mega, 10 mega. So you can clearly see here, 100. So frequency range can be selected from this switch. And this switch is the function switch from which we can select the function, that is square function, triangular function, and rectangular function, RAM, pulse function, TTL function, sine wave function. So different function, that is the waveform we can select from here. And this switch is a modulation input. A modulation input signal can be taken from this function generator. So, and this is the menu. From here we can also get the clock signal of particular frequency. This frequency can be varied by using the frequency frequency knob. So now if we change this frequency knob, then we can get the data signal also. So here the serial data can be taken, and the beats can be changed of the serial data from 1 to 0, 0 to 1. This is the frequency counter. This is used for the frequency counter applications. It is taken from this switch. And modulation input can be taken from this switch here. And our output signal, that is any form of the function, we can take from this output 50K terminal. So this menu, we can select the data input also, and the serial data input can be taken from this switch. Here this modulation input can be taken from this switch. So different connectors are we can use to get different types of output from this function generator. Function generator is an input device. So here we can change the different waveforms as we have already seen. So duty cycle of the pulse signal can be changed from this knob, and this knob is used to vary the frequency gradually, and this knob is used to vary the amplitude of the signal. This switch, that is the DC offset switch, that should be off initially, so our DC offset will be zero. And this is the sweep pulse switch, and these are the all functions that we can perform on this function generator. Now connect the CRO probe from function generator output to this CRO. This is our cathode ray oscilloscope. Then the waveform can be appeared on this screen. So it has a x-axis and y-axis as shown here. This CRO screen have grids of 1 centimeter each. So each box is of 1 centimeter length, and it is subdivided into 0.2 centimeter. So this waveform is appeared on the CRO as shown here. This CRO here is used in a single channel mode only. So we can use the CRO in a two channel mode also. So now here you can clearly see this is the Y axis and this is the X axis. And here grids are shown also. So this is channel 1. If you press the ground button, then we can make sure that this waveform is in reference line, that is the ground line. That is the DC value should be on the reference line, that is the ground. So again, if you unpress the ground button, then we can see the AC waveform on the CRO. So from this knob, intensity knob, we can vary the intensity of this wave. It is a, we can focus on the wave, and also from this knob we can vary its intensity. We can make it more intense, or we can make it dim also. So this is the wave. Accordingly we can change its property. Focus, we can make it more focus and more intense. Now this is the Y shift button. If we vary this knob, then we can move the wave in Y axis, and from this switch we can move it in X axis. That is the Y shift and X shift are used to shift the wave in X axis and Y axis as shown here. Now this is the hold per division knob. This is for channel 1 voltage. So we can vary this hold per division knob, and this is the channel 2 voltage. We can connect channel 2 also here, and this is If you vary the voltage division knob, then the voltage of the waveform is actually voltage remains constant, but we can vary just voltage division knob to see it in large and small scale, but its voltage remains constant if you vary. And here this is time per division knob. From this we can vary the time per division of this wave. Make sure that we cannot change voltage and frequency by varying this volt per division knob and time per division knob. Now if you connect the second channel, if you connect the second channel of the CRO to this another function generator, for example, so now connect positive to the red and negative to the ground. Here we are going to connect the CRO in dual channel mode. Now if you press the button here, that is channel 1, channel 2, then if you press the button, then channel 2 will be appear. But if you press this mono button, then the CRO is operated in dual channel mode. Dual channel mode means simultaneously we can see two signals from two different input devices. So simultaneously two signals can be shown on this CRO screen, one on channel 1 and another on channel 2. So we can vary the amplitude from this function generator, we can vary the frequency also, we can select the different frequency slots here. So on the CRO screen we can observe the two signals simultaneously from channel 1 and channel 2 as shown here. So we can vary the time per division. A time per division knob is common for both the channel 1 and channel 2. So here both the inputs signals selected, that is both the functions are sine functions here. So we can vary the frequency. So simultaneously the frequency of both the waves are going to vary, because a single time per division knob can be used to change the time per division of this signal 1 and signal 2, that is channel 1 and channel 2. So now let us vary it. Signal of channel 2, vary its frequency so that we can see it exactly on the CRO. Now this is the channel 2 actually, sine wave, and from this function editor we can select the waveform that we have connected to channel 1. See, this both have different frequencies as selected from this function generator. We can select the frequency and amplitude from the function generator, and that we cannot change on the CRO. So triangular function, then ramp function we have selected, then we can select this pulse wave, then this is TTL wave, its voltage is constant, then sine wave we can select, this is the sine wave, then again we can select the square wave also, this is the square wave. We can shift this wave on y axis, that is the y shift, by using the y shift button, and we can also use the y shift button of channel 2 also. So y shift button of channel 2 is used to move the channel 2 waveform on y axis, and this x shift button is used to move both the waves on x axis. So here if you vary the frequency again using the frequency knob, then the frequency seems to vary on the CRO. So we can select any frequency up to 25 megahertz as per the specification of this function generator and CRO. So here both the channel 1 and channel 2 waveform we can see on the CRO. So in this way we can use this CRO in dual channel mode as shown. We can also measure its frequency and amplitude here. So amplitude can be measured like, so if we measure the amplitude of the channel 1, then first of all this is our, suppose this is sine wave. If this is sine wave, if you push this button, then this star goes to this channel 2 to channel 1. So this Hotepi division knob now will be work for channel 1 waveform, so as shown. So we can now calculate its amplitude also. So now if you again press this button, then this star moves to this channel 2. Now this Hotepi division switch will work for channel 2 output signal, so as shown here. So this both the waveforms that simultaneously appearing due to the dual channel operation of the CRO. So X shift and Y shift can be used. Now both the channels X shift and Y shift button separately provided on the CRO. So it's very flexible for us to move the wave in Y shift and in X shift. So you can clearly see here.